Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Last time we took on the Mirror Star Cup using Luigi here, and this setup was actually really damn good. And this time we are indeed pulling another combination from the comments, and this one was suggested by, let me find the name, 26Gonzalez7094. I feel like I've pulled one of his before. Hold on, I recognize that name. Did I do that one? I don't think I've done that one, unless there was one posted on like a really early episode that I'm not seeing when I do the search here. So give me 2 seconds, I'll do one more search. Oh, he just suggested Dry Bowser. He's the guy who just suggested that we do Dry Bowser. So he actually did suggest a full-on combination this time. So screw it, we'll use that. Cause this guy's getting two, I guess. I mean, the first one was just Dry Bowser, so. Anyway! Mr. Gonzalez over here, we're gonna be using Ludwig in the airship with the wooden wheels, and he did not suggest a glider, so I'm gonna go with the Bowser kite because that's the one that's got wood on it. So we're in this entirely wooden setup, and we're gonna be taking on the Mirror Special Cup with Cruise Cloud Top, Dunes Dry Bone, Castle Bowser's, and Road Rainbow. Let's go. I'll be honest, I chose this set, this comment because I liked the look of this setup. I didn't realize until after the fact that, that it was in fact the same guy from last time. I just recognized the name as I started to read it. And we already fell because I screwed up the drift. Alright, well, we've got a bit of a catch-up game to play at the beginning here then. But we should be okay. We're at the very beginning of the race. We've got, we've got all the time in the world. Alright, there we go. Oh, we're already back in first with a mushroom and a coin. Not bad. We should be a golden. Anyway, so I chose this this setup from the comments because I've actually played with the all-wooden setup before, and from my memory, it wasn't bad. Actually, one of my favorite setups to use with Ludwig is, I think it's the gold cart with the slick wheels or cyber slick wheels. But I figured, screw it. Well, I want to use one of the Koopalings because we used, what, Lemmy? And now we're losing. Now we're using Ludwig, so... Why not? We'll give him a fitting cart with it being the Bowser slash Koopalings airship. So, oh, that's a blue shell. Let's see if we can do this. I've never done this before. We avoided the blue shell! Holy crap! I've never avoided a blue shell in this game before. With a mushroom, that is. Alright. Okay! That's one for the books. Maybe they made it easier in this game, or what? But okay. I'll take it. So I guess you don't have to be pixel perfect, because I did that a little bit, or what I felt was a little bit early. Note to self, you can avoid them pretty easily. Okay. And we're still on the second lap. For a second, okay. For a second there, I thought we were on the third lap. But no. God. Avoiding that blue shell has given us quite the lead as well. Like, they haven't even passed the start line yet. They're just going around that last corner. There we go. Get our coins back up to 10. And another item. Oh, we missed the jump. We overshot the jump. That's not helpful, but okay. And, well, can't avoid that one. All that. Thanks, Mario Kart. It's hit us with 3 items in a row. Let's get this mushroom. Or not. Alright, alright. Well, it's a good job we picked up that lead, because now we're slowly but surely losing it. But there we go. Final section. Second to last section, I guess, technically. We're doing good. They haven't even arrived on this platform yet, so even if we get hit by a blue shell, I think we're gonna be okay. Or a red shell. Give me that. And down we go. Did we land on that cloud? Is that a solid cloud? I think that might be a solid cloud. Alright. Let's get as many coins as we can here, because we're kind of running low. 1, 2, 3. Use that. That's up to 7. Alright. God, that was the best race in this series so far, just because we avoided a blue shell with a mushroom. And that was a legitimate reaction, by the way. I've never done that. Alright, moving on. Bone Dry Dunes, or Dunes Dry Bone. Sounds a little inappropriate when you say it that way, but here we go. One of my least favorite courses in this game. I think I've mentioned, I like all the courses, but this has got to be down there at the bottom, just because it's so bland. Look at it. It's all just brown. There's no color to it. The music is probably not some of my favorite, but it does have some nice features to it, like the dry bones that are walking around. There's the giant dry Bowser statue, and of course the dry piranha plants as well. I like how they included all the dry-related enemies in this, but just overall, the course is kind of forgettable. See, there's the dry Bowser thing. Can we make it? Nope. And that shortcut's a pain to do as well, because they always make you think you can do it. Make it look like you can make it, but you can't without a mushroom. Or maybe you can without a mushroom, and I just keep doing it wrong. I honestly have no idea. Also, red shell. And the boo stole my coin right as I was about to hit the item button. Okay. Give me that green shell. And for a bit there, everybody was kind of all spread out. They're still kind of spread out right now, but when we went into this middle section, everyone on the map was all over the place. Also, I feel bad for Inkling Boy. He is currently in last place. Last episode, I mistook him for a blue shell. Now he's just sucking royally. So, Inkling Boy, I apologize. But if you want to see some first place Inkling Boy gameplay, we already played as him, so you can check that out in one of the earlier episodes. I think it's like episode 5. Maybe? I'm not too sure on that, but it's in the early 150cc episodes. Oh, I see a blue shell coming. I see it there on the map. Can we get something to avoid it? That's a coin. Can't avoid it with a coin. You can't just pay it to not kill you. So let's use it right there, get that right as we get hit, and immediately back up to 10 coins. Nice little pro strat right there. Alright, we're doing okay. Iggy's not got that much, okay, that sucked, but Iggy's not all too close to us. I mean, he is, but if we keep up without crashing, then he's not gonna be catching up anytime soon. There's two bullet bills flying around the course right now. Give me that double item box. We're on the last corner. Only the usual things could screw us up here, so I hope that doesn't happen. Avoid the dry bones. Excuse me. Oh, that's the usual thing! Alright, I think we're okay. Unless we get bombarded. I think we're good. I don't think there was any item boxes back there. There we go. First place. See what I mean about that race? That felt boring in a way. Like, the course doesn't do anything to excite you, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I'm just talking out of my butt, but maybe you enjoy this course. If you do, more power to you. I'm just personally not a huge fan. Moving on. If that course opening does not give you just, I don't want to say goosebumps, it doesn't make you think, oh crap, it's about to go down in this course, then it should, because as you know from when we've played this one in 150, I love this course. I've always loved Bowser's Castle courses, and this is no exception. One of my favorites is probably Double Dash, the Double Dash Bowser's Castle, which needs to come back, by the way. I feel like that would have been a perfect addition to this game as a retro course, but unfortunately not. They just keep bringing back GBA courses into these games. GBA Bowser Castles, that is. In fact, is there a GBA Bowser Castle in this? I think that was just in 7 and DS and Wii, I think? I'm not too sure on that. I don't think there's one in this game. I don't know why I'm forgetting that, but if there's another DLC pack, if they think that and decide to release another DLC pack, I would not be opposed to seeing Bowser's Castle from the GameCube version, because it's a good one. At the same time, I'm quite fond of the Wii one. I don't know how they would really do, like, the trick ramps, hit the brakes, there we go. I don't know how they would do all, like, the half pipes and the trick ramps and stuff in that course, because this game has tricks, as you know. Oh, okay, that happened. But it doesn't have the type of tricks that go up, like, half pipes, like, say, DK Summit, or like in Bowser's Castle in Wii. Don't punch me! Okay, we're all good. Actually, we had way more time than I thought we did. So, I don't know how they'd handle that. Maybe they'd just put fences up there so that you can't, thanks, Boo. So that you can't go up there or something, but I don't know. And of course, right after the Boo steals one banana, a red shell's gonna take the other from us. But we should be okay. I got the Ultra Mini Turbo. We've got an item box coming up. We have actually a really good lead. thanks for that. We actually got the item box right after getting zapped, meaning we kept the item, which is good. All right, we get the ultra right here. Probably not. Maybe on this corner though. Right here? Is this where we got the ultra last time? No. All right, never mind. Excuse me, ball. Yeah, we've got a big lead right now. Iggy's pretty far behind. I'm gonna hope he punches and brings his fist up before I get there. There we go. And in fact, even if the boost panel isn't lit up, it still works, which is pretty great. Alright, last stretch here. I'm gonna drop these items and get the double, because I want to try and get non-coin items. That is worse than what we had before. I'm gonna keep hold of the coin. Till the very last straightaway. That's a blue shell! Alright, we still got our lead though. We're all good. We got back up to 10 coins. And victory, okay. Iggy started to gain on us at the end. I didn't even see that blue shell coming on the map. There you go, Bowser's Castle. I love this course. I love all Bowser's Castles, like I said. Except maybe the N64 one. But then again, in Wii, it was brought back in Wii and it was okay. Anyway, moving on to this last race. Oh boy. Road Rainbow. Rainbow Road. If you watched the 150cc episode of this cup, then you know that it took us like 4 or 5 tries to actually get gold in this cup, because for whatever reason, the AI on Rainbow Road was out for blood. And just like that already, just got green shell sniped in reverse. So I am just hoping that it's not going to take that many tries this time around, because that legitimately made me a little angry when we played through that. Give me that. Damn it, Shy Guy. Have we even gotten an item yet? Now he's got triple greens, and I don't want to get near him. Nope, I boosted right into him. Alright, fine. Get your little lead. We're down in 4th, so that means we're going to get some good items. Screwed up that shortcut because I'm not used to it in mirror. Alright, give me that. I have a bomb and a mushroom. I'll take it. Now let's see, can we hit someone with this bomb? Get the ultra mini. Go! And of course they just moved to it. Blue shell is coming! Oh, boost away! I think it went for Iggy. We like got all up in his business just then. And then just boosted out of there. Alright, that should give us somewhat of a lead, never mind. Both of them passes already. I knew I was gonna screw that. Bye. I think that was Baby Peach or somebody. Cat Peach maybe? I don't know who that was. No, Cat Peach is in front of us. Someone pink hit our green shell that we just put out behind it. Alright, mushroom and red shell. I'll take that as well. So this time... Oh no, the shortcut was over the other side. Never mind. We can go like this. Boost across here. Oh, I should have waited. Oh, he took my red shell! Alright, coin and banana. Back in first place with first place items, of course. Alright, oh. Does he have a red shell? Oh, he had a mushroom. Take this. Nope, that was way too far. See, look at this. We just entered the last lap, and there's two people in front of us. In this course, for some reason, the CPUs are just a lot more difficult. Oh, god damn it! That's because I got the spin turbo off of Iggy. I swear to god, if we have to replay through this cup just to see that damn gold trophy again. Come on, friggin' Ludwig. Alright, there we go. He didn't go for the double. That's good. Green shell is not going to be much use, maybe? Actually, that's Luigi. I haven't even seen him up here before. Alright, at this point, all we really need is the protection. Something's coming. It's a red shell. I shouldn't have thrown that, but it was on the other path. Okay, we're good. It warned us about it, but it was on the other path. That freaked me out. Are we going to win? Oh, I think we've got it. Drop that. Oh, I explode him on the last freaking line. There we go. My hands are sweaty. I just wiped my face with sweaty hands. God damn. That was intense, but I'm glad we got it first try, so we don't have to replay through that. Not bad, Ludwig. Not bad.
Yeah.
just like last time, I'm glad that they showed the Rainbow Road race, because that was probably the best race out of the four. That was a lot of fun. And for a third time, the credits tried to play, but we're skipping those until the very end, so there you go. Anyway, with that, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Of course, next time we're heading into the Retro Cups, starting off with the Mirror Shell Cup. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. And of course, suggest character and kart combinations, preferably characters we haven't used yet, because I'm not repeating any characters in these episodes. So, yeah, thank you once again for watching. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.